Today, I'm going to show you how to create highlights like an edumacated individual. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNace. Today, I'm going to show you some awesome things you can do to create highlights in your image. These are something you've never seen before, and you're going to really love it. Speaking of highlights, there are a couple highlights from Phlearn.com. One is that we're giving away a free Phlearn Pro for Beetle Beauty, that's a lot to say, tomorrow in our newsletter. So if you guys have not signed up for our newsletter, go to phlearn.com/mail or go to connect and then see the Phlearn mail. Sign up for the newsletter. You get a free Phlearn Pro tomorrow. It's going to be awesome, and I can't wait for you guys to get it. We also have a contest. You guys can win over $1,000 in prizes. That ends this coming Sunday. So you guys have 3 days to enter this contest. So get your free Beetle Beauty Pro and sign up for our awesome contest. Just submit your image and you guys could win over $1,000 in prizes. Cool. Let's go ahead and get into this image. We got a lot to do today. I'm going to show you guys something that's going to blow your mind. All right. Here is our image. It's from a recent photo shoot. This is our amazing model, Ricky, and very, very cool image. We're going to do some behind the scenes with this. So I'll talk about the lighting and things like that. But today I want to show you guys a little bit about how to create some great highlights. But before we do, I need to talk a little bit about the theory behind how light works. But I promise it's going to be interesting. I'm not going to make it too boring. To do so, we're going to create a new layer. Now, I just want to zoom in a little bit, and we can see a couple. This is a cow skull, by the way. I love shooting with stuff like that. we can see a couple things that I'd like to draw attention to. One is the light here on Ricky's face, and you can see the light here, that actually is from this lamp. This was shot at a half a second shutter exposure, a half a second shutter speed. So this was actually a really slow shutter speed. There's a strobe coming in from the camera right, but this light all over here was actually from this lamp. That's not strobe light. So what I want to talk about is the color, the saturation, and the intensity of the light on her face. We can all look at that and pretty much agree that it's orange, right? I mean, that's the light color that's on her face. If you're not, you know, it's like, oh, well, maybe her face is orange. Well, you know, on a white cattle skull, it's still, you know, yellowish orange as well. So that is the color of the light that is hitting her face. Now let's go up here and we'll sample this light. Well, that's pretty much white, right? There's a pretty big difference between white and orange. And the reason why is whenever you have an actual light source in your image, what you get is the center of the light source is going to be not only the brightest, but it's going to be the least saturated as well. So you're not going to have much saturation on the center of your light source. As the light source goes out and decays with the inverse square law, meaning that every time you go twice the distance, you get half as much light. Every time that happens, you also get more and more saturated with your color, and you change colors through the color spectrum. So what all that means, and for those of you dorks out there like me, you're gonna love that. What all that means is when you're gonna create a highlight for, let's say you have a light source in your light, and you know those like really nice glows you can create on lights and things like that that everyone's a big fan of. If you just grab white, this is what most people do, by the way, when they wanna create light source or like a little glow. They will paint with this color, paint with white over here, and just like create a glow. Usually not that harsh, but they'll do something like this. The problem is that's not how light works. So we have to follow this rule that light, when it's closest to the source, is the less saturated, and it also changes through hues. So how can we actually do this in a way that's relatively intelligent? Well, you can do it by creating a custom gradient for your light source. Okay, not very hard to do actually. Let's go to our gradient tool. You can hit G for your gradient tool, and up here we're gonna click on our gradient editor. Okay, and for this, you can just start with any old gradient. Let's just start with this guy here. Now, the gradient editor here is going to go from this nice purple color to orange. Well, if you want to change the color, just click right here on your little bucket, click on your color, and then you can just sample right from your image. So we'll hit OK. I've sampled from there. Now, our end color, we'd like to be somewhere around here. Let's go ahead and just sample, you know, OK, that's what we want our end color to be. Now, in our, let's just hit OK. We'll get back to this in a second. In our color spectrum, you're going to see if we're going to go from white to, you know, like a dark orange or something like that, you tend to change hue down your color spectrum as well. You tend to get a little bit cooler. So what we're going to do is go from white, we're going to transition through yellow down into orange, because that's basically just how light kind of decays. So let's go back into our gradient editor, and then right here, we're going to choose something that's a little bit yellow. And if there was actually something, like if there was a white piece of paper behind here or a medium gray piece of paper, you could actually just sample on through there because you could see that. But in this case, we don't really have that. So let's just take this color. We'll sample it, you know, something there, and then click on our color there, and we'll just bring it quite a bit brighter and quite a bit lighter. Lighter and brighter. There we go. Maybe that's a little too green. But there you can see something that's like, oh yeah, you know what? That actually does look like how light kind of travels, which is perfect. Let's hit okay there. And so we got white traveling through this nice yellow into this orange. There we go. And that is with our gradient. Now, we're gonna actually use that to create a gradient over our subject. If you wanna grab your radial gradient, let's just create a new layer. Hit your G for the gradient tool. You can do something like that and create pretty much exactly something that's you can't use. So we're gonna create a new layer, and instead of using our radial gradient, we're going to choose our radial, sorry, instead of the linear gradient, we're gonna choose our radial gradient. And the radial gradient, basically where you click and kind of drag out, you're going to see that's gonna be your transition. So you're gonna have, you know, from one color on into another color. So this is basically how light travels through your image. And you can use this in many different ways to color your image. Not only that, but you can create a couple of these different guys, all right, in different sizes and kind of click and drag out. Very cool. Now we are gonna wind up using a mask as well, because we don't really necessarily want this orange to cover everything, but that's basically the idea of what we're gonna be doing. Okay, so let's go ahead and delete that layer. Let's create a new layer, and I wanna click inside of my light and just drag out. Something like that. So we've got our really nice transition here. Now, with this, you can do quite a few different things. You could change this to something like soft light if you wanted, which is just going to, you know, kind of color. We can change it to something like screen as well and lower your opacity. There are a lot of different things you can do. Now, if you want to kind of take it a little bit step further and maybe make it a little bit smaller, just hit Command T, take your little transform point, bring it to the center of your light, hold down the Shift key and the Option key, and you can just make that a little bit smaller. So if you wanted to make it smaller from the get-go, you can totally do that. But you can see how light tends to fall a little bit more naturally if it is, in fact, going from the center out. Okay, so let's just try it again. We'll just say maybe, you know what, I want to make this a little bit smaller. And then we'll put a layer mask on here. Now, your layer mask you can do basically the same way. You'll go from the foreground to transparent color. Okay, we're going to choose black, and we're going to hit this reverse key. And that's basically going to define where this light stops. So let's just do that on a regular layer so you can actually see what it looks like. But there we go. That's what it looks like. It's going from foreground to transparent, but I hit this reverse key, so it's actually going from transparent to foreground color. But if you're painting with black, it's going to go transparent to black. Okay? So that's basically how we're going to use our layer mask. We're going to go the foreground to transparent. There we go. Hit OK. Make sure you click reverse. I'm realizing now this is getting incredibly complex, but the results are great, so that's really cool. And you just learned something cool and fun and new about Photoshop. So here's basically the idea. And you can do this over and over again, by the way. You can just, you know, continue to lessen it up. And if you want to just hold down Command Delete, which will fill with white, which because it's my background color, and just do it again, you can do it again. So or you can just hit Undo, making it either larger or smaller each one of these times. But what we're seeing is that instead of, let's just go ahead and compare the two. So instead of just grabbing white and kind of going in here and painting like this, can you see how that just, it doesn't look, well, natural at all. It just looks like we just took some white and there's some fuzz over there. So now what we have instead is something that actually does decay like light decays. So when you're creating your glows, just like this, this is the best method to use it. Now, if you want to go through your blending modes, you can do that pretty easily. Just hit your V button on your keyboard, which will switch to your move tool, and then hold the Shift key and then click the, hold down Shift and hit plus and minus. And that's going to cycle through all of your blending modes. So you can see, you know, some of these are going to have some interesting effects. Linear light actually kind of looks good. I like the saturation that it's adding, but it's way too opaque. So we'll just lower the opacity of that. There we go. So each of these ways is a really nice way to create a light glare. All right, if we do want to, let's say this is one directional, you can see that there's like a back to this light. Let's just paint with white so you can see, you know, the light wouldn't go out in this direction as much as it would in that direction. So I'm gonna click on my layer mask. We're gonna paint black at like 20% flow, just over around the backside of this, just a little bit. So we have something that kind of flows out in this direction a little bit more naturally. So holding Alt or Option, click on your layer mask. That's what our layer mask looks like now. It still decays really well, looks great, and it fits with the overall image, and it follows the light, the laws of color and light. Well, thanks for watching Phlearn, guys. I hope you enjoyed your extremely dorky lesson for today on how light decays, but knowing that is gonna mean you're gonna be able to create some much more accurate highlights that transition across your image and won't look like they're fake, and they won't look like they're done in Photoshop. So guys, thanks so much for watching Phlearn. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will Phlearn you later. Bye everyone. If you want to talk fast like me, you should do Coke, a cola.